top 6 list of movies and TV series Michele Morrone has appeared in. The talented young actor Michele Morrone has been working hard, and it's very clear. Yes, very, very hard. If you know what I mean. Although all of his work has been in Italian productions, he is becoming an international star thanks to the Netflix movie 365 Days. Apart from this, he has also appeared in many movies and shows, but we'll talk about it later on. So just you wait and get to munching. Starface Productions is back again with another piping hot video about our sexy, sexy Michele Morrone. Subscribe, guys, and click the thumbs up button if you love our actor. Also, don't forget the bell icon for more Michele Morrone updates. We know you can't resist him. Here is the top 6 list of movies and TV series Michele Morrone has appeared in. Number 6, Duetto, 2020. In this movie, our lovely Michele Morrone takes the role of Marcello Bianchini. Duetto takes place in 1965 and tells the story of Cora, an 18-year-old Brazilian girl from an Italian family who, after losing her dad in a tragic car accident, goes with Lucia, her grandmother. They travel to Italy in the region of Puglia, where her old family home still stands. Lucia, aiming to sell an old family land lot, re-encounters a familiar face along with her granddaughter. They meet her sister, Sofia, and her husband, Gino, with whom she hasn't talked within 40 years. Well, so much for selling an old family land lot and having the money all to yourself, cause here comes competition. Things get complicated when the sale of the land turns out to be lost in bureaucracy and takes more time than what was expected due to the upcoming traditional music festival of the town, where the biggest Italian musicians of the time performed. Lucia and Cora end up being forced to extend their stay, and old family issues are revealed, giving Cora an intense journey of grief and growth, along with the unexpected, almost fantastical encounter between the girl and Marcello Bianchini, an Italian cantautore and an idol of her deceased father. By the way, did you know that Michele Morrone is a musician? No wonder he was cast for the role. You can check his songs out on the internet. Number 5. The Trial, 2019. The series begins with the introduction of Elena Guerra, a prosecutor who is later asked to investigate the murder of a 17-year-old girl named Angelica. However, it is soon revealed that Elena is going out of her way to solve this case because Angelica is her biological daughter, who she had abandoned when she was a child. Opposing her is defense attorney Ruggero Baroni, who tries to prove that Linda Monaco, the only defendant, is innocent. A hefty courtroom battle ensues between the two. You can imagine an intense sword fight going on between the two. Just kidding. It just involved arguments and legal paperwork. Anyway, the deeper they delve into the details of the murder, the more they learn about the blemishes in their biased justice system. That is true in real life too. The Trial is like a soap opera that intends to explore the depths of crime procedurals. Even in that regard, it is quite credible and manages to translate its content with other Western shows of the same genre. Even in its final moments, instead of confining itself to a firm conclusion, it gives a more realistic view of crime solving by only portraying the imaginative projections of the attorneys and their insights on how the murder unfolded. But apart from this, there's another aspect of it that you can notice if you empathize with Elena's character, which is a tragic yet cathartic journey of a mother who tries to mend the mistakes of her past. With each episode, the stakes of the case get higher. This either happens because of the involvement of many other players in it, or simply because of how the personal lives of the attorneys start melding with it. Speaking of the prosecutors, Vittoria Puccini is just brilliant in her role. She perfectly encapsulates her character's guilt and struggles to come in terms with her past. On the other hand, Francesco Siana, who plays the role of the defense attorney, also does a fairly good job and truly shines during his scenes in the courtroom. The final act of the trial plays a key role in establishing its overall stance as a crime drama. In its closing moments, it could have easily fallen into a crushing melodrama if it had solely relied on building up its mystery to a big reveal. Instead, it eventually ends on a rather bittersweet note, revealing that the truth behind the girl's murder may not exist at all. As lawyers, they can just make sure that they're on the right path and they're serving justice instead of succumbing to their egos or desperation for success. Michele Morrone portrays as Claudio Cavalieri in the television series titled The Trial. So, what's Michele or Claudio Cavalieri's role? Well, he becomes a prime suspect for Angelica's murder. His alibi is his wife Linda Monaco, played by Camilla Filippi. Don't worry, Michele. The only thing you're guilty of is the crime of being too hot. Number 4. Medici, 2019. This series premiered in Italy on Rai 1 on 18 October 2016. The series follows the Medici family, who are bankers of the Pope during Renaissance Florence. Each season follows the events of a particular moment of the family history, exploring the political and artistic landscape of Renaissance Italy. The first season, titled Medici, Masters of Florence, takes place in 1429, the year Giovanni de' Medici, head of the family, died. His son, Cosimo de' Medici, succeeds him as the head of the family bank, the richest bank of Europe at the time, and fights to preserve his power in Florence. The second season, titled Medici the Magnificent, takes place 20 years later and tells the story of Cosimo's grandson, Lorenzo de' Medici, known as the Magnificent. A third and final season, which completes the story of Lorenzo, premiered on Rai 1 in Italy on 2 December 2019. The series reached between 4 and 8 million viewers on original airings. He played as a ship captain for just 2 episodes. It's better than nothing, right? Also, who wouldn't love a hunky ship captain? Number 3. Bar Giuseppe, 2019. In this Italian movie, Michele Morrone played as Luigi, and no, it's not Mario's brother. Giuseppe suddenly loses his wife, with whom he ran a service station with an adjoining bar on a busy road in Puglia. Not receiving help from his 2 adult children to run the bar, he hires Bikira, an 18-year-old girl who has recently landed in Italy with her 2 adoptive parents. Despite the great difference in age, the 2 fall in love and get married, creating a scandal in the provincial town. Whoops! Later, the girl tells Giuseppe that she is expecting a baby, claiming that she has not been touched by any man. So she's saying maybe a man staring at her intensely got her pregnant? Don't fool us, Bikira. Number 2. Provaci Ancora Prof, 2005. An Italian production television series broadcast by Rai 1 from 6 November 2005 to 19 October 2017. Inspired by the stories of Margherita Orgero, Michele Morrone played the role of Bruno Sacchi in the first episode of Season 6 in September 2015. Yeah, only one episode, but Michele had to start somewhere. Number 1. 365 Days. You really thought we wouldn't mention everybody's favorite, 365 Days, did you? As you all know, Michele Morrone plays as Massimo, the lead character of this movie. Massimo is a member of the Sicilian Mafia family, and Laura is a sales director. She does not expect that on a trip to Sicily trying to save her relationship, Massimo will kidnap her and give her 365 days to fall in love with him. Yes, here comes our hot stalker. The 2 eventually fall in love in wet and wild ways, and perhaps in more ways you could think of. Probably involves ropes and whips. Maybe we'll see more intense yacht action in the sequel. Wait, you don't know that there was a sequel? If you didn't, you could check out our video, What We Can Expect from 365 Days Sequel, and get ready to feel the excitement rush. And that's the climax of our video about Michele Morrone movies and the TV series he appeared on. Subscribe to Starface Productions and hit the bell icon for cool and trendy updates. If you like our video, click the thumbs up button. Also, drop down a comment. We'd love that. And cut. Till next time.